What's up, people? What's up? This is your boy, K Solo. I want to wish everybody out there Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, man. I hope your holiday was beautiful. As for mine, it was okay. Spending it in my house with my wifey, just us two. Like I said, it was okay. Just, regular thing, wifey and husband and wife. I'm enjoying a nice, quiet night. What we did, we had a nice meal, no question about that. Wifey cooks up and real good. I mean, banging, you feel me? Banging. So I ate a little something, and of course the salad gotta be there. The salad gotta be there right next to me, you feel me? So no question, I took care of that. Anyway, so just to leave it out, just wanna say happy, Merry Christmas to everybody out there, and we got one more to go. We got New Year's Eve. Once New Year's Eve is here and it's gone, no more holidays. You feel me? Because the holidays could take, it could really knock you out, man. It takes a lot out of you. Believe that. All right? So anyway, yo, listen, this story is about bullpen therapy. Bullpen therapy, bro. Plain and simple. You know, a lot of people don't talk about the bullpens, about when you first get locked up and you got to go through the bullpen shit. And then once you go to Rikers, then you gotta go to the bullpens over there too. Son, bullpens, bro, costs at least 2 days of your life in the bullpens. No bullshit, ask anybody. Back in the 80s, there was people staying in the fucking bullpens for 5 days. There was people dying in the bullpen because people was not getting their medication. You had diabetics, you had people that was on that was HIV, you had people that had bronchitis. Oh man, the bullpens, that shit was like a fucking big giant box of fucking cheeses with fucking disease. Cheeses, you know the box of cheeses? Like a big box of cheeses with disease. I'm serious. The bullpens was nasty. And like I said, they used to keep you in there for fucking days in the 80s and early 90s. What happened was a couple of lawsuits here and a couple of lawsuits there, they stopped all that bullshit. Now that I think they got 48 hours for you to see the judge. 72 hours, I forgot what, 72 hours or 48 hours to see the judge. And if you don't see the judge at that time, you dismiss. Dismiss. Case is dismissal. Trust me. So anyway, these are some of the shit that you gotta deal with when you go to the bullpens. You ready? Okay, for example, what's up, guys? Yo, what up, Playboy? Yeah, I'm doing my things about the bullpens. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people talk about the island, but they don't talk about the bullpen therapy. You know what I'm saying? That shit can take a lot out of you. Yeah, so anyway, so boom, right? So like I said, a lot of people don't talk about the bullpen. So this is some of the shit they gotta deal with in the bullpens. You ready? All right, for example, when you first get locked up, you already know, the fucking cops come, they throw you, and everything starts from that fucking van. Everything starts from that fucking van. When they throw you in that motherfucker, it's a done deal. So, you go into the van. Oh, fuck me. Hold up. Damn, you know something, guys? I got to go back home, but fuck it. Make the story longer, because I got to go back home. I forgot my wallet. I got to go back home. So anyway, this is how it is. You ready? Thank God I didn't walk too far away from home. So anyway, so you get locked up. You already know you get locked up. They take all your bullshit, your wallet, your keys. Do they take money? I don't think they take your money when you first got locked up. I don't remember, but I don't think they take your money when you first get locked up. So now, you're in the fucking bullpens. They got you. They took all your shit away from you. Next thing you know, what's up, Bobby? Alright. So next you know, they stick you in the precinct bullpen. That's the first motherfucking bullpen you get to see. The precinct bullpen. You feel me? You go into that precinct bullpen. The first thing is, that's when they fingerprint you and they do all that crazy shit. First of all, the fingerprints. I'm sorry you can't see me, guys. I'm on the streets. So the fingerprints. I know a lot of you guys know what's the fingerprints, and I know a lot of you guys don't know what's the fingerprints. So, first thing you do when you get out that bullpen is you get your fingerprints. That's it. That's it. That's the only time you come out the precinct's bullpen is to get your fucking hands fingerprint. Get your fingerprints. After you get fingerprint, you don't go nowhere else. You go right back to the bullpens. Unless they don't have a toilet. If they don't have a toilet, then they have I'm pretty sure they got a room where you could use it right there, blah, blah, blah. Just like, but that was back in the days. Now, they got bathrooms. I mean, they got toilets in every fucking bullpen you can name. Trust me. They got toilets in all those bullpens. So, all that shit about walking out, that shit is dead. So, anyway, so now you take off, you know, you take the bulletproof, hear me? You take your fingerprints, okay? Then you go back inside. After that, now they pack you up. Now, not pack you up, but they tell you, yo, get ready. Now you go into the court. And the court is the one that people used to get rocked. Now, I'm talking about in the precincts, back in the 80s and early 90s. So imagine the 70s and 60s. Imagine those times. But I know in the 80s and the 90s, you could stay in the fucking precinct bullpen for at least a day or two. A day or two. And that's bouncing to precinct, different precincts. You feel me? You can go to the 48th precinct, you go to the 49th precinct, you go to the 41st precinct, 42nd precinct. I talk about the Bronx. You understand what I'm saying? You go to any of those precincts, the longest your arresting officer comes and gets you out. So they got at that time, they had a certain time to keep you in there. And I believe it was 12 hours. That's why they just switch you around many times. So once you in the fucking precinct, I mean, not the precinct, once you go to the court, from there is the first motherfucking floor. It's where you're going through, and I'm talking about the Bronx and Brooklyn, same old shit, Bronx, Brooklyn, Manhattan, same thing, same therapy, you feel me? So now you go in the first floor, especially in the Bronx, they open the fucking door, boom. I'm talking about the old Bronx bullpens, the old Bronx court. I'm talking about the new one. The old one, you should come into the side. To the side. So they open the door, all inmates come out, or anybody that just got locked up, people that got locked up, they come out, the car, boom, they stick it to the side. First thing you see is a fucking, I don't call them COs, because they're not COs, they're police officers, first court officers. First thing you see is the first, yeah, let's call them CO. You walk in, you see the CO. First thing he tells you is go into that little room. You go to a little room. It's like a little small fucking tuna fish can room. I swear. As a matter of fact, sardine. It's like a little fucking canned sardine room. I swear to God. So anyway, they stick you in that room. You be in that motherfucker for about, you could be in that motherfucker like about two, for about an hour or two with the handcuffs on. No bullshit. With the fucking handcuffs on until they decide that they got all the paperwork done, so they decide they talk all the bullshit they need to talk, and then they decide to take the fucking handcuffs off you. So now they take them off. Once they take them off, you go, and I mean, this off you, they take them off you. So now, you in the motherfucking, like I said, in the bullpens in the precinct. So you in the, they take you out that room, right? That's the room where they question you. They pick a counselor, a caseworker, and they ask you what's your name, who you want them to call. You know what I'm saying? You know, this is like your, this is the information they get from you. You know what I'm saying? This information also goes to court. So they tell you who's your mom. I mean, if you have your mom, so you stay with your wife, moms. If you're married, not married, they tell you if you're sick, if you're not sick. You know, they ask you mad questions. A lot of people, and I did it before too, when I first got locked up, I didn't know this lady didn't know nothing about court. She was just there for one job. And I remember when I told her I was copping my plea. This is the first time I got locked up. I was copping my plea to her. I was like, ma'am, they caught me and they did this to me, they did that to me. And I didn't know this. You know what I'm saying? The lady's like, sweetheart, calm down. I was crying, I ain't gonna front, man. I was crying, man. I was scared, 16-year-old kid, man. going to Rikers Island, man, and hearing all this crazy calm chaos that was going on. So I was fucking scared. So next thing you know, I'm talking to her like if she knew anything. She didn't know nothing, man. You know what I'm saying? She did not know anything about the courts. So once you deal with that, you go to the first floor, bullpens. There, you could be there, bro, like about, there's no bullshit. You could be there for about at least 9 to 10 hours in that one bullpen. No bullshit in that one. Wow, guys, I hope this shit don't turn off. Hold up, man. I hope this don't turn off, guys. Give me 1 second. All right, I had to twist the door. Anyway, so you... No. I ain't finished yet. I forgot my fucking wallet, baby. I forgot my fucking wallet. So you imagine how tight I got. Well, I didn't get mad, but, you know. Anyway, I'm telling the story, mommy. Anyway, so in the bullpens, right? After you finish the first floor of the bullpens, like I said, you could be there motherfucking 12 hours. No less than motherfucking 8 hours. I don't want to hear it. No less than 8 hours. Not unless there was nobody in the bullpens. There's nobody downstairs. You feel me? It's like, it's very rare, but it happens. It happened to me. You know what I'm saying? I got to the first floor bullpens in the courts, and was there maybe for about an hour. Whoop, go upstairs. So yeah, that can happen. Very rare, but it does happen. But anyway, the shit, it could be packed. You could have, there's no bullshit, bro. Downstairs, bullpen from the motherfucking courts. You could have up to 30 motherfuckers in one little bullpen, bro. 30 motherfuckers in there. I'm serious, the shit is packed. Nobody could sit down. The fucking benches, in the bullpen are mad thin that it's very rare you could sit on it. Anybody could sit on it. And they do that because they don't want you sleeping on it. You feel me? They don't want you sleeping in the benches because it's very uncomfortable to sleep in the bench. You feel me? So that's why they do it mad thin. Why do you think they did that in the train stations? You know, when you go to the train station, you see that dividing. When you sit down on the bench, you see that dividing. That divide is like real small. They did that for people not to sleep in the bench. Hey, they got smart. Anyway, now, once they take you from downstairs, then they pack all you guys up. All right, guys, you're going upstairs. All you're going is really to the second floor. In the second floor, that's a whole process. That's just waiting. Now you're in a waiting game. And the second floor in the Bronx court, it was like you got 1, 2, 3 cells to your left. And no, 4 cells to your left, I believe. Yeah, 4 cells to your left and 4 cells to your right. The cells to your right only was used if it was mad packed. And let me tell you, late 80s, early 90s, all the way to the 2000s, it used to get packed. And I'm talking about both sides, left and right. Especially, I gotta say, especially in the late 80s and 90s, bro. It was when the crack ever came out and all that, yeah, it was crazy packed. So anyway, you stay in there now. Son, you can stay in that motherfucking bullpen. This is no bullshit. They used to keep motherfuckers in there, bro, for 2-3 days, bro. The longest I stood in that bullpen, I could say it was 3 days. The first time and the second time I got locked up. 3 days. No bullshit. So now, you in there, eating that fucking stale-ass bologna and fucking cheese. I'm serious. Back in the 80s and 90s, for breakfast, they used to give you 2 milks, 2 boxes of cornflakes, and an orange. And I do believe some coffee, maybe. I think so. Something like that, maybe. But I know they used to give you 2 milks, 2 cornflakes, and an arrow or a fucking... I mean an arrow, you hear me? An apple or a banana or an orange. That's what they used to give you. Okay. Now, all they give you is motherfucking old-ass cheese, the bologna... That shit is green if you're lucky. If you're lucky, it's green. If not, that's my word. The fucking bologna is so nasty. that you can see fucking pus oozing out that motherfucker. I'm just kidding. But that's how nasty the shit looks like. So I'm not lying. That's how nasty the shit looks like, fucking like somebody's skin that's rotten with pus coming out. That's how nasty that bologna looks, bro. So when you get bologna and cheese, my suggestion to you is look at that sandwich and look at it very well. Feel me? Or not, you get the motherfucking peanut butter and jelly. Oh my God. I used to call that cement sandwich. Cement sandwich is because once you wet cement, what happens? It gets wet, it gets dry, and it gets hard. So that was the shit in the motherfucker. When you bite that motherfucker, you're like, you're, it used to be like a sponge, B. All your saliva, used to like go into the sandwich, gets wet, you swallow, and that was it. Your mouth is dry. So now you're eating that sandwich mad dry because you don't got no saliva. You feel me? And this shit, the bread, you can tell the bread is mad old. I mean, you can tell the shit is like cardboard. Now you're eating cardboard, fake cheese, fake bologna, or fake jelly and peanut butter. Fake peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. Shit tastes like cardboard. But anyway, you in there. Then you finally, when they finally call your fucking name, you go upstairs. That's the bullpen that is crazy small, and they have like, damn son, if I could remember, but they could stick like 15 to 20 motherfuckers in that bullpen. 15 to 20 motherfuckers in that little bullpen. That bullpen is, the next stop is that, is to see you talk to your judge, I mean your lawyer. Your lawyer comes out, calls your name out. Yo, Rivera, Johnson, Peterson, whatever your last name, bro. They call you. Boom. You answer up. Yeah. Not like that, but you already know. Not like that, but you already know. Some dudes be like that, yeah. Once you get used to it, you be like, yeah. Hold up, man. This is not culture. Wow. I was about to say, yo, I got to go home again? I left my credit card in the house. I was about to say, yo, I gotta go home again. What the fuck? So anyway, right? So now listen to this shit. Now you see your lawyer. Now you see your lawyer. You talk to your lawyer. And once you got all that down pat, you go to the bullpen, right back to the bullpens. Okay. You go right back to the bullpens. Once in a, hold on, guys. Let me get with this tree. Heard? Go get my cop the trio. Yeah, I'm telling people how the bullpens is, or how they were back in the days. You know what I'm saying? Like in the 80s, 90s, bullpen therapy, baby. You don't watch football? Oh man, that's why I'm running back over to see my football game. Thank you, man. Get out here, baby. I see that. Yeah, guys, yeah, you already know. Had to get the tree. Some people don't like, you know what I'm saying? You had the camera on them, you know. Anyway, what's up, Nana? Thank you, baby. So anyway, so now you're in the bullpens, right? So next thing you do is now you go see the motherfucking lawyer. I mean, the judge. Once you speak to your lawyer, you go see the judge, all right? So If you're lucky, let me get one bologna, this one. Yeah, if you're lucky, you could get to go home. If you're lucky, if your case ain't all that, you go home. If not, you got to bail. And once again, if you're lucky, you got that money to get bailed out, or your family got that money to bail you out. Once again, if you're lucky. And also depending on your fucking case. So, you know what I'm saying? The worst case for me, I ain't gonna front, was the one that I caught in 80 and 85, my first time when I got locked up. And thank God it was the first time I got locked up, because not an armed robbery with a 30-30 scope. Let's say if you have a record like the record that I got right now, and you get locked up for that shit that I just said just now, son, you're looking at least, first cop out. First cop out. 12.5 to 25. With the record that I got now, you get caught for robbery somebody and they got you with the gun, armed robbery. You got the witnesses, you got the people that you robbed. They got the gun, the shit that you robbed. It's guaranteed first offer, criminal court. It is 12.5 to 25. Now, you don't take that 12.5 to 25, you get indicted. Indicted means you go to Supreme Court. Supreme Court could raise your shit up, bro. It's very rare that Supreme Court could come down on your case. Could gun down, you know what I'm saying? Because you could also have Supreme Court, and they'd be like, you know something, shoot it back down to criminal court. It's not worth Supreme Court, you feel me? You could have that, but once again, you got to be very, very, very fucking lucky. You feel me? So anyway, so now you're in Supreme Court. You already know.
Eat it.
You get out of there. All right.
I'm not.
Let's say you don't get bailed out. You don't got no money. Your family can't afford it. Your pops, your moms, your bail's too high. What's up, Leah? Your bail's too high. You can't afford it. Let me get one dragon and two Philly cheesesteaks. Yeah, matter of fact, let me get one Philly cheese. No, two. Make it two. Yeah, so let's say you're lucky. I mean, you're not lucky. You can't get bailed out. No bail. Your family don't got no money. You don't got no money. Your bail's too high, or they don't give you bail. So you know, you're very lucky, man. If you get out of that motherfucker. So let's say you get out. Now you go on to the island. I mean, not get out. Let me rephrase that. Let's say once you finish the court, go downstairs. Now you're waiting for the bus, what you call the Rikers Island Toto bus. That's what you call. What's up, man? See you later, baby. So now you're waiting for the island. You feeling me? You're waiting for that fucking bus to come pick you up. Now you're exhausted, bro. I mean, your body, you're hungry. You're fucking hungry. I'm telling you that right now. Your fucking stomach could be touching your ribs. You're hungry, son. You know, you're thirsty because you don't want to touch that nasty ass water. You don't want to touch the fucking sinks. You want to take a shit bad. You can't take a shit because you cannot shit. Well, that's 30 motherfuckers in the cell. 30, 40 motherfuckers, B. Nigga, you taking this shit and niggas right there in the toilet? That's crazy. So anyway, now you go to the island. There's no bullshit, bro. And the island, once you're in the island, you lost. You gone. They could do what the island could do, whatever the fuck they want to do with you in that bullpen, son. So now, you go to C-74, C-95, wherever you go, it's gonna be bullpen therapy again. You will not see your bed. I say you will not see your bed for about another day. For about another day, a day and a half. You will not get a bed. I'm serious. All right, so once you get that fucking bed. No, wait a minute. Once you're in the bullpens in the island, you wait another day and a half to get a bed, right? But while you're waiting, they got you sitting in the fucking cell, standing, sitting, whatever the fuck, laying down. You tired, you're exhausted. I seen niggas sleeping in the fucking under the bench. I mean, yo, it's crazy. Everybody smelling.
You spare $1 or $2 so I can get my medication?
Baby, I don't got it. All I got is a dollar for this right here.